have another holster to do, and this is going to be very similar to, actually, it's exactly the same as the one I did for a shoulder holster recently, except this one's for a Beretta 92, and, or a clone of a Beretta 92, and he wanted a thumb break on it, so it's going to be a little bit different, and it's going to be left-handed. But it's basically, it's for the brother of the guy that I made the other shoulder holster for. So he wants the exact same shoulder rig. So I'm not going to go through how I did that. I'll just go ahead and, you can always watch the video of the previous shoulder holster and apply the lessons learned from this one. So the pattern is, the back piece is something I drew up myself, and this is going to be where the straps for the shoulder holster attach on these three points. The holster is just going to, holster pocket's going to be sewn onto this. And the holster pocket itself, I decided not to bother reinventing the wheel. I don't need to redraw that because I have a pattern that has holsters for a Beretta M9, which is a Beretta 92, basically, in Will Gormley's pattern packs, M7 system pattern pack. I'm probably mispronouncing his name. But he does some pretty good patterns, but he says they're for advanced leather workers. What he means is he doesn't actually explain much of anything to you how to do it. So he just assumes you know what you're doing. So that's the basic ideas we're going to have. Go the other way around. That piece attaches on there. Thumb brake's back here. The only problem with this is the thumb brake is going to be right against this piece of leather. And it may be hard to push that out of the way enough to get it to pop loose. So we're probably going to put just a little bit of a spacer behind that leather piece, just a skived off piece to just step it out just a little bit from that edge. And then that should do the job. Now on the pattern, I've got marked RH, that means right-handed. So if this is up the grain size of the leather, then I'm making a right-handed holster. And if I need to make a left-handed holster, all I have to do is turn it over to the other side of it. And then that's how you make a left-handed one. They're just reversed. Grab basically the same piece of leather. We're going to cut out a couple pieces to line it. We're going to go further down on the belly of the hide because it doesn't much matter on the liner. And we're going to turn these pieces around. And just roughly mark them. Because we'll trim our liner to match later. chip. It's got the drum brake set there, which should work whenever I've got something in it. It doesn't work real well without having anything there to work against. And this holster can be worn as a cross-draw holster, or even a strong side holster where the barrel is canted forward and the grip is back. But it's really designed to fit a shoulder rig, and a particular type of shoulder rig that these customers requested. I've made another video already about that shoulder rig and holster that was very similar, even had a Grim Reaper on it. That was for one customer, and now this one is for his brother, who is left-handed, and that's why this is the left-handed version of the holster. For a different firearm, this is for, I think I mentioned before, a Beretta 92 knockoff. But anyway, we'll go ahead and grab it onto the shoulder holster. Shoulder right here. And I made it to where it can be taken on and off pretty easily because, like I said, the holster can be worn on a belt as well. And that just makes it a little bit more versatile. But first of all, everything is just put together with screw posts. Loctite or glue them, but that kind of defeats the purpose of a screw post, I believe, so I don't do so. Back. This goes across the belly. Got a quick release snap on it. This is what actually holds it up on the shoulder. And there's the holster. And as I said before, I've got a video already of how to make this shoulder rig. And also one of how to make the magazine pouches that fit on it.